Все может получиться.
Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Another day here at Room on Fire. Wow, that text isn't supposed to be there. There we go. Now we should be just about ready with the upcoming games here. It's going to be Penta Sports versus LDLC, but we have a really long night ahead of us. And let's see if I can get Semler and Vendetta online. How are you doing, guys? We are just about ready here with the game. At least we have five people on, so we're halfway there. But, you know, how's your day been so far?
Pretty good. Can't complain. Had some, a bit of a rough experience on overpass solo queuing and matchmaking. But yeah, other than that, it's been perfectly fine.
Ven, you lived. You survived, bro. I'm so proud of you.
I dared to dream, and here I am.
Truly amazing.
Oh, there's a lot of static, is what people are saying. Hopefully not. Can you guys hear me all right?
Yeah.
No, I can hear you perfectly fine.
Is there any static for you?
I mean, sometimes when you're speaking, Ven, it sounds like there's like a little bit of like basically wind going on.
Like there is a fan right behind me?
Yeah, maybe like it's a little bit too close to your mouth, maybe? I don't know.
It's probably okay. The fan that's standing right behind me.
All right.
I don't hear it though. I can't hear it. So.
All right, sound is fine. People are saying it's fine, so I don't know. Maybe it was just a troll.
Maybe. Oh, is the wind sound going away now? Has it dissipated?
Yeah, maybe a little bit. Look, guys, if something comes up, then tell us in the chat and we'll try and deal with it. Obviously, we don't want any kind of issues, but I'm certainly hearing you guys just fine. No issue at all. And if you're hearing me fine, then hopefully that's all it takes for everything to be cool. Don't want any mic issues, of course, in the middle of the show. This is going to be a pretty intense day, I feel like. I mean, yesterday we saw some crazy, crazy upsets, and actually even some games that I thought were going to be a little bit maybe even boring. So today I'm just sort of ready and waiting, because today's games are going to be absolutely anything but boring. Just to go through what we have here on the menu today, it's LDLC versus Pentasports. The first game coming up here, Pentasports used to be Berserk, in case you can't recognize them here. Then we have Na'Vi playing Epsilon. It's going to be a really fun game. Then we have Titan versus Epsilon. And then we have NIP versus Titan. And then we have VODS Pro versus ESC to end the evening with. But obviously, El Clasico in the middle of the night is definitely something, isn't it?
That's perfect. That sounds like a fine night of CS to me.
Yeah, definitely I'm ready for it. I mean, this is... And the fact that this first one is going to be on Dust 2 as well. I guess, Semler, maybe you don't know, because you had other engagements yesterday, but we actually saw Pentasports beat Na'Vi on this map yesterday.
Yeah.
And now they're playing.
Na'Vi beat Penta on Dust 2, but Penta really showed that they... they knew what they were doing.
I'm sorry, it wasn't Penta that beat Na'Vi. Yeah, it was Mouse Sports. I'm sorry, yeah. I'm mistaken. Was that Mirage? Am I making everything up right here? Who beat? Yeah, was it Reason that beat Na'Vi on this map then?
Yeah, that's how it works. Correct. Yeah.
All right, I was bound to get that right. Essentially, someone beat Na'Vi on this map yesterday. That's that's basically the message here. I'm sorry I got that all wrong, guys. But yeah, actually, Penta did play really well on this map against Na'Vi. But I actually have a sneaky suspicion. I think LDLC is going to be a tougher opponent right now. Just because I have a feeling the Frenchmen are really, really psyched to be playing. I mean, Semler, you've been talking to them. Are they hyped up? Are they practicing for the upcoming tournaments?
Oh yeah, they're in full practice mode right now. Every night starts at 18, and they're practicing as much as anybody out there right now, I think. So, no, I mean, the thing is, there's so many tournaments happening right now. We just announced it tonight, but we will have LDLC in the Case King of the Hill tomorrow. And then I believe Apex, at least, is going to be playing at Assembly this weekend with Overdrive.
All right.
But of course, I mean, I think the big thing that everybody's pracking for right now is Gamescom, which is only 2 weeks away.
Semler, tell me, what other team are we going to be having tomorrow then in the Case King tournament?
I think it starts with an N. The Dirty Swedes. Who is it again?
Exactly right. It's going to be a lot of fun, right? LDLC and IPS the first game tomorrow, and then the winner versus Na'Vi, who are the kings for the third week in a row. And actually, on that topic, guys, if you haven't done it already, then there are a bunch of links at the bottom of the stream. You can go and click. One of them is for the thing for tomorrow, and also the other one is for the YouTube video that's down there, a little bit of a commercial. You can watch Semler and I acting at a pretty high level, so you can definitely go and do that. But this game, we have almost everyone on the server, just missing two more people, and then we should be good to go. So I think it kind of goes without saying, LDLC are the favorites going into this one. From what we saw last time, from Penta Esports here, Vendetta, I mean, who are the people to watch, do you think, in that game? I guess Asmo did play pretty well, and actually, who else aside from Asmo? There were a couple of people in there that did well.
I want to say Rack and Crystal were probably the most impactful players that game. A bit of a change in Penta from last night till now is the fact that Felix is playing today, and AlexR is not playing, and if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure they have a six-man lineup, so yeah. That doesn't mean that, you know, somebody's gotten kicked or anything like that. It's just Felix is back, and I think that's a massive boost for Penta, because Felix is easily one of the better players in Germany.
Well, see, that is interesting. That really, because actually AlexR played so well with the AWP. I remember now, I'm getting old, but now it's coming back to me. I'm pretty sure Alex got a lot of opening kills with the AWP, and Crystal didn't have an open. That's what really threw us the first time around. We were wondering, why isn't Crystal opening? So do you think now that Felix is back, that means we are going to see Crystal opening? And I guess it's going to actually change a lot about the Penta lineup here, having Alex instead of, or Felix instead of Alex here.
Yeah, actually, I wouldn't be too surprised if we didn't see Crystal pick it up, because he made it work pretty well on the B-bomb site with only Colt. For a large portion of the game, actually, at least on the CT side, and we saw Solid picking up the off to maintain control over mid. So I wouldn't be surprised if that was this kind of how they played it out on the CT side. But on the T side, it's definitely a possibility that Crystal starts picking up the off.
That'll be interesting. I'm still waiting for the day when he returns to that weapon and does what he did. Like we said yesterday, last year he looked really good with it, but hasn't really been committing too much to it, and I guess that's alright. I mean, as you said, he did pretty well anyway, so it's not like it's necessary for him to do it, but on Dust 2, you do want someone with a strong AWP. I guess Solik is the other guy we sometimes see AWPing for Penta, so that could also be a thing. We'll have to find out. Of course, we know who's going to be AWPing on LDLC side. That's Kaylee. He is definitely someone you got to be ready if you're going to face Kaylee.
You got to be warmed up. Maybe go DM some, burn some incense at the altar, that sort of thing, right? Because you really do need to be on point to take on Kaylee with a sniper rifle, especially on Dust 2. I'm really looking forward to the shenanigans at mid-doors.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I guess the theme anytime we have a matchup like this where it's an underdog playing a clear favorite, it's just that there's a lot of stuff that has to go right. You know, we have to see strong individual performances, and that's important. But I will say this, though. It felt to me like Penta, apart from the individual performances, they also showed us some pretty good teamwork. They showed us that they had their heads in the game against Na'Vi when they were playing on here. So that's good. I mean, that's really good. And actually, I think Penta are going to be at Assembly too, aren't they? I'm pretty sure they are.
Penta are going to be at Assembly, yeah. So, six of the players that are on this server will be at Assembly. And what's really cool is that I believe we have Public Clear. But yeah, publicly are going to be at Assembly, and that's actually Python Schneider. So I'm really looking forward to getting to actually catch up with Schneider a bit and see how things are progressing with his new team.
Yeah, because they didn't make the qualification, did they, for Gamescom?
No, unfortunately, no, they did not make the qualification. I can't remember who actually knocked them out.
Encore.
Oh, who was it?
Encore, the Finnish
Encore,
guys,
that's right,
who
Encore, yeah.
Later got knocked out by Copenhagen Wolves.
But that there's going to be like potential rematch, of course, then, because Encore is going to be at Assembly. What's really interesting, actually, I think, and everybody's kind of like wondering right now, who's going to be on Overdrive's team? Because we know Apex is going to be on Overdrive's team, but that's the only player that's been announced, apart from Overdrive himself. So there's another three slots to be filled, and we're supposed to know within a couple of hours, apparently. So who's not playing that they're going to be able to get?
Well, obviously, first thought that strikes is, well, they're going to go back to something similar to the lineup they had when they won the Prague Challenge, right?
Yeah, but what? VP?
They're not there as well. Yeah, that's right. So, I guess, well, Kenny S is not an
option. He's on Titan.
So he's going to G3 as well. And I'm assuming we'll see some of the Russian guys, maybe a couple of Hellraisers players. Maybe
it's just been announced. Yeah.
Oh, it's just been announced. Apex, Kaylee, Overdrive, Pimp, and Schneider.
Oh,
whoa!
That's an insane lineup.
That's a pretty cool lineup.
Man, I love Overdrive's teams. They are just so much fun. That is actually it's really not going to be boring watching this team play. It really won't be. If anything, we can absolutely guarantee that, right?
Yeah, you gotta love the fact that like it's such a random mix of players. That's what I love about these teams.
Yeah,
like Overdrive just hops in, just asks a bunch of people like, "Yeah, do you wanna go to a LAN event?" And they're like, "Yeah, sure." And all of a sudden, you probably have five players that've never played a single game together going to a LAN event, and they're probably
gonna do really well as well. Yeah, man, this is going to be sick. Pimp and Schneider, too. I mean, Apex and Kaylee. Well, hell, we've got Apex and Kaylee on this server right now. Kaylee, obviously, we're just singing his praises. But then Pimp, super versatile. Schneider, we all know what a madman he is. This is going to be sick. This team is baller.
But what happened? Wasn't Schneider supposed to play with Pyth?
I thought so.
Well, maybe he's going to play both teams. Double the chance of winning. All right, look, guys, we're going to get it on here. It's Penta Sports versus Team LDLC. You're at Room on Fire, and this is the SLTV Star Series Season 10. It's a best-of-one game on Dust 2. I'm Anders, with me is Semler and Vedetta, of course, and we are going to be bringing you your whole evening of Counter-Strike here. Five games coming up, and this is only the first. In the middle of the night, we have NIP playing Titan, which is going to be a sick game. So thanks for tuning in. Remember to follow and subscribe, and now let's get ready. It's going to be LDLC starting on the counter-terrorist side, and Penta Sports starting on the terrorist side, which... we'll have to see here. I mean, the Germans are the underdogs, but I mean, it's been a whole week full of surprises so far, so let's see if we can keep it up here.
Ah. Yeah, this is going to be perfect. Sorry, I closed my window because there's still some traffic going by, so I don't want it to be picking up too much on my mic.
If they rush B, you got to be kidding me. They're rushing B. Uzi's going to be alone. This is headshot time, Uzi. He's going to go for one, but now if he repeats, it's really dangerous for him, and the backup is pretty far away. They're making a swift rotation, LDLC, but that was perfect coordination, or perfect choice at least from Penta. Really nice start for them, at least.
Well, this is a nice start, but now they have to weather the storm because everybody rotated over from LDLC immediately. Asmo's going to find Uzi waiting on B slope, though. Peekaboo.
He jumped on top of the box and took him down. But Maniacs is angry now. He's going to be taking down one Kaylee with another shot coming in. And it's a 3-on-3. They have a kit on Maniacs, so he has to stay alive here. And he will. Now it's a 2-on-2. Asmo and Felix cleverly waiting outside. This is actually a very smart play from them. Now it's going to be really hard for them to defuse here. Felix goes for the kill, gets the one. Maniac repeats and takes him down. And I'm not sure that's enough time. I think Penta did it. Oh my god. After a triple kill for Maniac, it wasn't enough. And the game starts hopefully just as well as it's going to go on here. That was a perfect start to this game, I think.
Happy had to stay alive there. That's the problem. Him getting insta-dinked pretty much kills it because they bring it to a 2-on-1. And then Happy just instantly dies. So Maniac has to come off the defuse. Just great play there from Penta.
Yeah, and it was the exact same pistol round they used against Na'Vi. So, sure, they have a new player in Felix instead of Alexar, but it seems like the strategies is pretty much the same.
Yeah, I mean, it's obviously a risk, right? If LDLC had had two people in B and one in middle, that would have been a very different round for them, but it's still fun to see it work out. Flash goes in, Maniac's gonna peek afterwards. CZ 75 in hand, gonna take down one, runs out of bullets, otherwise it would have been a clear double kill. Solik is gonna go down eventually, and this is a great round from LDLC. Very nice recovery, and all it took was a single flashbang. Such an easy thing to pull off, but it works so well when executed like that.
Yeah, with CZs as well, it's really powerful. They managed to get their hands on the bomb, though. That's the most important thing. And now Kaylee has got an AK to use as well. Uzi with the flank from Mo with Dark catches Felix out. Asmo is still alive, but not for long. Uzi assassinates him. And that's two weapons saved on top of everything else for LDLC. Talk about a second round win.
Yeah, a real shame. And Penta, I think, apart from losing the two players up on short, I think they got really, really confused after they did that. They seemed like they had a hard time recovering from it because they had a lot of time to work with, but they sort of walked into a second trap after walking into the first one, and that was maybe a little bit silly. But that's how it goes. LDLC, as we said, they are the favorites here, and there is a reason why that is.
They're in general just monsters. That's the thing. Clear favorites. They're definitely, I mean, potentially a top 8 team right now, so that's a pretty big gap. I'm already usually getting dropped down to 1 HP. I like the Penta are already able to strike back. They're going to lose members, but still doing some pretty significant damage here to LDLC. And there's the first kill for Felix. Apex is taken out at the mid-doors.
Yeah, they do have actually a rifle and an M4 on Felix. And if they were on the CT side, they'd say, oh, they should try and save it. But, I mean, it's pretty hard saving against four people and there's this much time left, basically.
Yeah, and the benefit of it isn't really there because if you potentially get picked up after the clock runs out, then you're beyond screwed.
Oh, great shot from Felix. Goes for a second one here on Maniac. If he can get the bomb down, but they're not going to allow it. Maniac with really good movement. I like the fact that he decided to actually move up towards the ramp instead of down on long, because I'm pretty sure if he'd run down on long, that would have been a bomb plant for Felix and a much better round for Penta. It's already a good round, but that would have been a really good round.
Yeah, no doubt. And, well, again, we see Penta doing kind of the similar thing that they did last night. Basically just investing a fair share into their anti-ecos. And I mean, I think they're one of those teams who are perfectly okay with getting two kills, even though they didn't get the bomb plant.
I don't think it's going to rattle them too much. Headshots from Uzi like that, though, are going to be a little bit unsettling. Solik, just not even time to react, gets nailed. Kaylee catches Crystal trying to sneak out from A house. And at this point, Penta Esports, it's really not going their way as far as even getting on the map anywhere as a group. They just got picked off one after the other. So pretty textbook anti-eco coming out from LDLC there.
Yeah, going into the fifth round, it's going to be no AWPs on the board yet. But, right now I think LDLC don't really need to try it. And if it starts going downhill, they know they can always fall back on Kaylee, and that will be a really good ace up the sleeve. So, yeah, I think this is all pretty reasonable for both teams.
Yeah, so Penta were in a kind of an awkward money situation, seeing how they lost the first anti-eco, and that's kind of why they weren't able to buy up with Ops in this round. But I don't think it's going to phase them all that much.
Let's see what they're going to go for here. Maniac is down in the pit, so if they can drop him, that's definitely a big opening into the map. They've smoked off the middle, try and deny LDLC too much information, but obviously with Uzi this close, he can hear a lot about what's going on all across the mid and short area. Kaylee up here is maybe going to get flashed in. Yes, the flash. Kaylee peeks once and will spark rack and corner. That flash works once more, and Felix is going to have to fall back again. So same trick and almost the same amount of success here. Maniac down in the pit is going to be a swarm. Just a lot of people coming in, and he's going to get the one there. Actually, a bit of a screw up there from... I think they should have been able to kill him without him doing anything there. He took way too long to react.
And this sets up for LDLC to just get the defense rolling on the A side. Uzi flanks out Solik on Cat. And now Penta, I mean, they're caught on long. Kaylee finds the headshot on Felix that drops the bomb out in the middle of nowhere. It's all down to Asmo now. 1v4, he gets one parting shot, but this is pretty much all he's going to get. He's down to 10 HP, and there's the flank. So LDLC, not too concerned about losing two guys here. I think they're going to be much more happy with just having the round on the board and living through another buy round from Penta.
Yeah, I think the fact that they didn't just instant kill Maniac when he was down there that basically screwed the whole round for them. And they could have just walked in and taken him out. There was almost nothing you could do. If he had hit like a straight headshot, that would have been it. But he took a long time to do anything.
Well, one thing you noticed is that LDLC are really taking Penta at face value here. Because that smoke went down on mid-doors. You all immediately saw LDLC. They only left one guy on B slope. They started rotating towards mid, putting Apex, who was holding his CT, putting him closer to CT slope, like just building up the defense, shoring up the defense for the A site. So it's right now LDLC aren't getting faked out too much by anything Penta are throwing at them.
No, that's really good. I mean, if they're just playing their game, and now Kaylee's even picked up an AWP. Obviously, there's an eco round coming up from Penta. It's almost certainly going to be 5-1, especially with Maniac flanking in there. Look, he's just right in between them, letting them walk in. Gets the 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh my god! Maniac! Absolute surgical precision there in that flank. That is actually really rare. Even though it was an anti-eco, that's still something beautiful there for Maniac.
That's nice and solid play. Having the patience to just let Penta show themselves, basically give away all their positions and making it easy for him. But yeah, that's why he's one of the better teams in the world.
Yeah, it's shaping up, I think, like most people expect it, but obviously a little bit of a shame for Penta that they lost that second round, because that now is really going to cost them. We can see how much it's hurting them. This could be, you know, a 3-3 scoreline instead or something like that?
Yeah, what's worrying me more than anything else really is the fact that there has been opportunities for Penta, but Crystal up to this point has been whiffing shots left and right. Like, he has not been hitting a single thing. And that's worrisome, because last night versus Na'Vi, he was able to connect with shots, and he needs to do that if they want to win.
Solik is going to step it up instead, and now Apex waiting outside here. They're not going to check the corner, and that will cost them dearly. Apex takes down one and almost the second one as well inside the bombsite. Happy's ready to pick it up, so we're back into a 2-on-2. Felix and Rack ready and waiting, and might be able to get a shot if Maniac pushes through the smoke here. Felix actually turns around, and it's going to be a good kill coming in here from Rack up from the upper dark. Now, Maniac's trying to see if he can really ruin that there. I think if he wins this round, I'm not sure if Penta are going to be able to recover.
No, this is too tricky. Look at this. He turns away. That was so close for Rack. He turns away just as Maniac is coming through the smoke, and he's able to react in time, pull a 180 and get the kill. But that would have been horrendous if Maniac managed to sneak through the smoke like that and turn it into a 1v1. No idea if Penta would have been able to hold there. One fun thing about that last round as well is that was a double AWP buy for Penta. Asmo had picked up an AWP as well as Solik. He went out to a long house, and that's where Kaylee got him, at long house immediately. So Penta, I mean, in large part due to Solik's frags, were able to bring it back. But it looked kind of dicey there for a moment at the beginning of the round, at least.
Yeah, really scary. Kaylee in the middle here, trying to take a shot through. They are sort of trying to take this mid control, but they are really worried about Kaylee, and I don't really blame them. Wish they would use some smokes to just make absolutely sure he's not going to do anything. He's going to take down Crystal, and again, the lack of smokes here is really hurting them in the middle. They have Solik on the other side, but it's not good enough. Apex is going to take down Rack, and now we're in a 5-on-3, and this is, I don't know. If they wanted to challenge Kaylee down there and not smoke him off, then they certainly went about it the wrong way.
Yeah, if you want to challenge Kaylee, especially when he has an off, at least put your best card up against him, right? So yeah. Have Solik take that duel instead of Crystal, trying to basically run him down.
Yeah, you know, get someone to throw some flashbangs, you know, at least try and see if you can get some better odds on your side. It seemed like they just ran in there with AKs and hoped that Kaylee wasn't going to shoot at them.
This is really cool from LDLC right now. They can see it coming. Penta Esports making the call. They want to go to the B site. Although now Uzi switches over to the B slope. He needs to get back in this site fast. This is LDLC focusing on this B site right now. They need to get the defense in here fast. And Uzi getting an incredibly important kill.
Yeah, Happy walks out. Perfect timing. And it's just going to work out fine. I mean, I think you said it. They had the defense for that B bomb site locked down pretty well. And okay. Now, I mean, the money they have and the rounds they have right now, it feels like Penta, they're going to be really hard-pressed to try and make it back from this scoreline.
You know what's a little detail there? Penta, I'm really not surprised that they go for B like that on a man-down situation, because that's something that they, at Copenhagen Games, they talked a lot about with Titan as to how their defense works on B. So, it's a bit of a situational thing, but there was definitely an emphasis put on, you know, you want to go for A for the weaker site, and B is going to be the weaker site on Dust 2. So Penta really setting up to go in there, but LDLC also following one of those basic tenets, which is you never leave a site when you have a man advantage. You always leave at least one guy on that site to defend, and Penta, you could see, were clearly hoping they'd have that 3-on-1.
Maniac again with the flank coming up. This time it's not as beautiful as last time, but he still gets the job done. Almost a triple. Asmo survives on 20. Of course, Sneak around coming out here from Penta, and actually some good kills coming in from Asmo. Not that it really matters at the end. I mean, yeah, LDLC lose a lot of rifles here, but the money they have is so much that it probably won't have any impact on this game right now. So there it is. I mean, good, clean, basic countersight coming out from LDLC, and Penta are finding themselves in a bit of a pickle here. They're 5 rounds down on the more favorite side of this map.
And I think we're going to see a direct P rush now.
Well, yeah, happy. Seems like a the spray from Uzi. He's going to pick down one. Picks up a Galil that he actually killed some guy from. And then it's going to be down to Asmo and Solik. So the B rush has been cancelled.
What? Kaylee just shot Maniac in the side of the head. What for?
Oh, no.
Okay.
Disobedience.
Yeah.
No, but that was like willfully shooting Maniac. He was looking at a house, and then he turns and shoots Maniac in the side of the head, and then goes back to looking at. I'm wondering what's going on in the French team speak right now.
Maybe you just Maniac didn't even steal any kills. Maybe, I don't know.
Maybe he doesn't even have a helmet. That did a lot of damage. What's going on?
I guess they're trying to give Penta a chance. Who knows?
I'm feeling generous. If they can get this kill in the middle on Uzi, that'd be really, really big. But it's not going to be easy, especially not when he reveals that he's there. Uzi has such a big chance of taking this. Any kill missed right now is going to be instant death. Asmo's going to walk right in. Does actually get a kill on the other side, so pretty good job from Asmo. Either way, Solik, 30 seconds left. He can do this.
Sure, but Uzi's playing this smart. Calls back to wait for his teammate. And now he's just looking from B slow. Bit of a challenge there, but he came out ahead in that, dropping Solik down to half health. And now with both of these LDLC members here at the same time, Solik, he shouldn't be able to hold this. He can play it to try and turn it into 1v1s by hiding behind this big box like this, looking towards window, or looking towards door one at a time. But LDLC should be able to just go in both at the same time and overwhelm him.
Yeah, grenades in. He's not flashed right now. One's going to come in. Almost takes the kill. That would have been such an important kill. He gets the one. Now he's down to 5 HP, and Maniac's going to be charging him here. Solik trying to play the clock. Just wait for it. It is not good enough. Maniac has just enough time to defuse, so he's not going to be able to win that 1-on-2, unfortunately. Would have been a big round coming out from Penta if they could have had that, but it's just not working for them right now. It's hard to find much positive to say about what we're seeing here.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that play there, Ben?
From LDLC?
Yeah.
I do not agree with Molotoving off your second entry point into a bomb site, no.
Yeah, it seems really weird. You need to go in one at a time?
I was thinking about, Kaylee shooting Maniac in the head and then them Molotoving off their only alternative route into the bomb site. I thought that was interesting to say.
Are they actually trying to make life harder for themselves? That's what I'm wondering right now. Is this like willfully trying to make their lives more difficult?
Who knows?
Happy gets the one, and in the smoke, Felix is hiding. He's going to go down next, and they have not that much equipment, but they have some here on Pentas. They've made like a weird buy, actually, with a scout and a Galil. One of them is going to go down, and now it's just Asmo's scout left. I really don't know what. I think maybe this is more than anything just LDLC realizing that this game is not won yet, but it's very close to at this point, right?
Yeah.
But this is kind of what Bush.
Yeah, this is kind of what we talked about last night, Honors. Penta or Berserk, as we've known them, or Alternate for that matter, they're a team that either shows up or they get trampled.
Yeah.
And I think this is a clear example of one of the times where they don't show up at all. I mean, Crystal is currently rocking one frag.
Do you think it has something to do with the map as well?
No. I don't think so. No, I don't think so, because they played really well versus Na'Vi last night.
But did they get a strong start versus Na'Vi?
No, they lost both pistols.
Okay, well then.
So yeah. I'm not really sure. It just seems like they have a on and off switch, and when it's off, everything just goes down the drain.
Yeah, then it's really, really off. I mean, this time they got a good pickoff on Kaylee, but this sort of pickup is what they needed when they had the fourth round, when they were just buying. Happy in the middle is going to take down one before he goes down, which is actually even a little bit more than maybe he should have. No, sorry, that was Apex. Uzi up here is going to be looking for a kill, and Crystal will be taking the kill on him. So that's pretty good news. Now it's a 2-on-4, but LDLC might as well go for this. They have so much money that it really doesn't almost matter.
Yeah, the big thing here for them is to inflict damage to Penta. Penta are the ones who are low on cash right now, and any rifles that LDLC can get off of them would be big. Asmo in a great position to catch Apex off guard, though so close to CT spawn, Apex never saw it coming. And now Maniac is kind of just set up for exits, but Seems like Penta should be able to pick up this round without losing anybody else.
So, if it finishes 9-6, and they win the pistol round so they can make it 9-9, and Crystal and Solid pick up 2 AWPs and just turn out to switch it all on again, there's like a minuscule chance that they can win this game. But I mean, we are talking about absolutely astronomical odds against Penta right now. And, you know, they still have to deal with another, what, 3 buy rounds here from LDLC.
Yeah, I mean, I think the probability of Penta coming back into this is like Denmark winning in any sort of Winter Olympics.
Hey, we won curling at one point.
At one point, I think that's the key word.
It's like, dude, curling is, it's like the middle of 90 too. Or something. I don't actually understand how curling is a sport, but we definitely did something, I remember. Uzi is going to be going down there, rack ready and waiting, and I think another sign, I would say Uzi pushing up like that, maybe another sign that LDLC are really just, you know, throwing their weight around a little bit. Like, just trying to see if they can get something happening.
Yep. It's really just them, you know, whatever, taking a risk. It's not a big problem for them to go for it. Apex on this B slope, though, he's going to get mowed down before he can get anything done as well. Now it's all down to Happy. Big kill here to start, 2, make it 3. Just barely doesn't get it. Crystal will spray him down with 6 HP left. And we're into a 2-on-3.
Asma in the middle, really sick flashbang coming in from Kaylee. Is going to make it a 2-on-2. And then the double spray down for Maniac. They lined up right here for him. And that's pretty much it. That was, yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, obviously Happy just sealed the deal, right? Those two kills really, really ruined the day for Penta.
Yeah, really, not a lot of things going Penta's way right now.
Such a shame. I mean, I don't know. I think even if Penta had won the 3 rounds, if they hadn't lost the 2nd round, I still think we'd be seeing a very, very strong performance from LDLC. But, you know, for the Germans' point of view, it's a little bit of a shame that they couldn't at least have got, you know, up to the maybe 6 rounds that they would have had. Nice shot from Solik there. Right through the door, catching Apex and actually crossing over the other way back to CT spawns. That was a good shot.
Wow, really nice reactions there with the flick. And we actually may see Penta in a pretty decent position here. It's going to be a play for Long. Maniac is the one waiting on blue here. And they check the spot. Nicely done there by Crystal.
Kaylee missing a shot upon short, and now he's sort of in a weird position because they're sandwiching him in. He's actually going to get himself smoked off from Long, which is not the ideal position. Uzi's going to take down Felix, and this is back into a 2-on-4 now, and Uzi and Happy, I mean, we're in the 14th round, and they have money to buy an extra round anyway, so they can just commit to this. Try and see if they can get the retake.
Well, let's see. I mean, smoke is clearing now. Happy is going to have eyes from CT slope. Spots Rack, but Rack, more importantly, spots him, so they know exactly where one of them is coming from. They know that Uzi is up on Cat as well. He gets flanked out, but not before taking Sulik. And now it's all just down to Happy. 1v3. Impossible situation.
Yeah, definitely. Good play from Asmo walking all the way up behind. That's very smart. I mean, they were using the fact that they had a man advantage. They realized they were going to come short and CT spawn, basically, so there would be no one long. And Asmo just, I mean, yeah, he could pretty much do that almost for free, so it's good that he did it. Oh. Solik's really fast with the orb. I mean, that's a really good shot down the middle onto Uzi. It's nice to see that, but now Apex is pushed up this far. Look where Apex is looking right now. That's a really unusual position.
Is he waiting to... No, he's not even waiting to get flashed out.
No, he's
not.
I'm
not really sure. I guess he's anticipating a flash from Penta, but that seems risky.
I think the LDLC are going for risky plays, though. Pushes yeah. Into upper dark, plays on Cat like that, you know, at long. It really does seem like LDLC at this point, when they've got 10 rounds on their CT half, they're feeling pretty damn good about the position they're in.
Yeah, I actually have a reasoning why that might work, and I'll try and share it with you in a second, because we're just going to be watching Kaylee here, maybe taking a shot on someone who's coming in. I think that's Felix trying to take a peek here, playing a dangerous game, and comes out on the bottom, unfortunately. Yeah, we're in the 15th round here, and as the score kind of shows you, LDLC have been playing a very fine first half here.
Yeah, not really a lot you can poke at when it comes to LDLC at this stage. I mean, they're on the less favored side as well. And they're just playing fairly standard CT-sided play, but they're just executing really well.
I think it's just, yeah, it's that combination of execute and just being able to land all their shots, really. They seem to be coming out ahead no matter what happens. Kaylee with his second frag, he finally gets caught by Sulik, who seems to be the only guy on Penta really able to go toe-to-toe with anybody on LDLC right now. Another frag for him, picks up the headshot on Maniac at long, and now Penta are in a good position. They've got the man advantage in a 3-on-2.
Yeah, rack down here, AWP in hand, spots Uzi, misses the shot. That was definitely not a shot he should have missed. Solik really on fire, as you said, gonna get a kill. Actually, he's just gonna assist that one, but he almost got that kill, and he's gonna get the last one here on Uzi. So, if anyone has to do anything, apparently, it's either Solik or Asmo on this team right now, which is not quite enough, as we can see. Now, so try and follow this this train of thought here. You know when you're running up the middle and you want to go short, if you're going to go short really quick, it's not uncommon to bounce a grenade off of the corner of the tower, whatever it is, that's like right by the CT doors. So you sort of, you know, you're running up and you're running and you just bounce the grenade in. I'm wondering if that was the grenade that Asmo was waiting for. Because if they threw it...
Definitely.
Apex was anticipating in a flash
from
Penta, but it's still an extremely risky move.
Yeah,
I
but
mean, you,
if
you get rushed on short, or they come from a lower dark, and lower dark, you're screwed pretty much.
Yep. Yeah, but if I'm just saying, if it ever worked, if that risk ever paid off, and the T's, you know, threw that grenade and they were running, there's a really good chance that the first guy you peek against, he doesn't even have his weapon out yet, and everyone else is behind him, unable to shoot at you. So it could be like a really interesting mow down. But I mean, obviously, it's a bit of a crazy play, but just saying.
Trying to find
it's living life on
here.
The edge, yeah. Man. It's living life on the edge.
Wow. Oh, by the way, Anders, Denmark has won one medal in the Winter Olympics since 1948.
Oh, hell yeah. Well,
and that was in 1998. How many
has Pakistan won? I mean, I don't know. We can't be the only country that can't.
But you're from Scandinavia.
But it's not
you
really
good at this.
I don't think you can bring desert countries into this, man.
The thing is,
you should be able to, you know, hold a lot of the Olympic sports, Scandinavian pride here.
A lot of the Winter Olympic sports has to do with skiing and stuff, and you got to remember Denmark is entirely flat, like completely
cross country.
You should be so good at ice hockey.
You should be so good at ice hockey and cross country skiing.
Well, we'll take for being good at Counter-Strike again. Who won the championships last time? The national championships?
I can't recall.
I think it was Denmark that actually beat France as well. We'll see. I think that's good enough for us. Asmo's going to be falling back, and we'll see if Penta can win this pistol round. Really good flashbangs are going to bring Asmo down ultimately. He also looked a little bit confused, so I'm not really sure what that was about. Now they're playing for a retake here.
Yeah, and there's a forward position here by Happy. They're just going to come. They're going to clash on short, and it all goes LDLC's way. Happy with a double kill. Uzi gets one. Kaylee cleans up Rack, who was trying to get sneaky from CT spawn. But that was LDLC putting their foot down. We are like, nope, this match is done, gentlemen. We know you're coming short. We're going to kill you all. It's not a problem.
So, I don't know. That was a really weird round. Obviously, the retake on short got pretty much destroyed. But the initial flashbang on Asmo and then a follow-up flashbang when he was trying to fall back and... It just seemed like he just looked really confused. I'm not sure if that was Asmo's fault or not, but it definitely was some really good flashbangs from LDLC either way. And now, at this point, now it's just as boring as it sounds. It's pretty much just a question of pulling out the string here. Because what can Penta do at this point? Pistol round was one of the requirements. First half finished 10-5, and now it's very likely going to be 13-5 here before they can put up any kind of defense.
It's not looking good here, Crystal. FB getting sprayed through the doors. There's Uzi making sure he finishes the job. Done right. Oh yeah, both rounds so far. Both rounds really just coming down to LDLC landing the shots because they didn't do anything special. They didn't do anything crazy. Like standard flash for long, standard flash into cross before you get to sight. Like, I mean, they haven't done anything crazy in the pistol round or this one, so it's just them. I think this is the difference between having confidence and not, really. This is the thing. They're able to walk into these situations and get the frags because everything's gone their way so far. Whereas Penta have to build themselves up again. And again, entry frag goes LDLC's way.
I think that's what it comes down to. I think you're absolutely right. So it's just hard to cope with at this point. And I don't know. I based on what we've seen from Penta the last couple of days, I'm still just... I think this team just needs to stick together and play more. And then they can make some pretty good improvements, I think. So, you know, it's hard to judge them. That's what it is. I mean, you put them up, as you said, against one of the top 8 teams in the world. And you expect, you know, what from them? It is really hard, right?
I think the weird thing about them is that you never know what to expect. Not because you don't really know what they're capable of in terms of, you know, they could pull out a really good game and bring it all the way versus LDLC. As we saw, they did a really good job versus Na'Vi. The thing is that you never know, like, what team shows up. Is it going to be the lackluster Penta, or is it going to be the surprising Dark Horse?
Yeah, it could be.
So yeah, but yeah, I completely agree with the fact that, you know, they should just stick playing together and try to find that consistency.
Yeah, one of the things I actually remember talking to Asmo about at Copenhagen Games this year was how it's a little bit hard for some of the German teams, he said, to actually find really good practice partners, because a lot of the other teams, I don't want to say they sort of exclude them, but maybe they just don't really want to play them all that much. You know, they're maybe more focused on practicing against each other than they are against Penta or Mouseport or something like that. So I don't know if that's pretty not the whole story, but I guess that could also be that even if they do play a lot of Counter-Strike, they, you know, it's only when they get to official matches that they have a really good chance of practicing, as it were, against, you know, a team like LDLC, and that's obviously not a good time to learn what the opponent is doing when you're losing to them.
That's very true. Obviously, though, I mean, official games like this will end up being a pretty valuable lesson for Penta if they're able to figure out what they're doing wrong. But yeah, exactly. It's not like they're in a unique situation. A lot of the up-and-coming teams are not going to get practice versus NIP the first day, right?
Well, so nobody wants to practice with NIP.
Nobody wants to get dominated. But oh. Yeah, you know.
Look, Happy's going to jump down right behind Asmo and take him down. That actually brings us into a 2-on-2. So far, it's been a really close round this time. And actually, now it's a 2-on-1. Apex is going to be able to put down the bomb, but can he actually hold on to it? I mean, they are pretty far away right now. They're actually leagues away. And if they run to A to check it first, that's going to be hilarious.
Oh, that's lucky.
That's what's giving it away.
Okay, it's a pretty big tell.
Half health, but he's still got a molly. He's still got a molly, actually. This could be fun here for Apex. He can burn quite a bit of time off the clock, literally.
Oh, you're right. Well, let's see here. He's in the corner, gonna shoot it up. So now he knows they can pretty much only come in through window. And one of them, well, they switch out the AWP. That's a really good move. Apex is gonna get flashed, and it does go down. So it's a good retake after all. But not that I want Penta to lose, but I sort of wish he hadn't thrown that smoke, just because it would have been funny to see them run all the way to A to check it and then realize, oops, the round is lost.
Yeah, it was actually looking really scary for them, because both of them were walking towards cave. And if they were in cave when that bomb goes down, they're obviously going to run towards A first. And by the time they get to the A-bomb site, if Apex had held on to the smoke and the molly for all that time, then what, they have like 15 seconds at best to retake the site completely?
Yeah. Oh, no. Samla, they went for a double-up setup, and Maniac just killed one of them in a really good position for Solik as well. So that's just a sick shot coming out.
Good prediction for Maniac. That's the thing. He was able to get there fast enough so that if Solik went for the back plateau, Maniac would be able to cut him off. So that was really nicely done there by Maniac. Just confidence, again, it's just confidence that's making the difference here. Asmo up on Cat is going to run. He has to fall back. In fact, he's getting chased by two guys, but good timing with the anti-flashes forces LDLC to fall back at least a little bit.
He's going to be running down on long. Kaylee's peeking out towards short, and he's going to pick off Felix. So now that leaves Asmo in a very uncomfortable position where he's been backstabbed by Happy, and has faced three people up here. It's a really good headshot. Goes for another kill, but he's not going to get it. Kaylee is too fast, and this could be game right here. Penta do not have a lot of money, and if they lose this round, and they definitely will now in a 1-on-3 here. 1-on-2, and that's it. Apex will take him down, and that's it.
You notice the confidence from Kaylee as well. He was taking that shot at Asmo at Rack blind. He got the first kill on Asmo and then goes still blind and almost picks off Rack. Just completely blind with the AWP. He came close.
Yeah, well, I mean, at this point, they can just—it feels like LDLC can just do anything and it'll pretty much work. They have this game in the bag, and it's how it is. We'll see if we can get a different sort of Penta lineup next time. They are ecoing here, which means they're basically fighting for a draw, which I guess that won't happen either.
Not likely.
Nah, not likely. One can always hope, I guess.
But that is a pretty, I mean, going back to the Copenhagen Wolves, our Copenhagen Games point, you know, the talk that you had with Asmo, I mean, that is the feeling you get from Penta, is that when they're at officials, that's when they really get the prac. Just going off the conversations they have with other teams as well, such as the one that I overheard between Titan and them. So it's like, maybe if they have a bit more time, or if they're able to put a little bit more time into it, we can see the real Penta, the the capability of the team.
Yeah, it'd be really nice. And they also seem to be a team that's struggling a little bit to find a proper organization to support them with. So I'm hoping that Penta are really going to, you know, help them out. I don't actually know anything about the Penta organization, you know, before they picked up this team. So I'm hoping that they can support the Global Offensive team here, because that helps a lot too. It really does. If you have the proper support, then, you know, there is a chance you can put a little bit more effort into it, and it goes a long way.
Well, we're going to see them at Assembly this weekend, so a little bit of that LAN experience coming in. And they're going to be facing Kaylee and Apex, so perhaps a chance for revenge on LAN. That would be pretty nice. But again, Apex? Apex catches him.
That was a really good shot. That was an enjoyable round that he landed right there. And we're at a 15-6 scoreline here. It's the first match of the evening. We have a lot more games coming up for you guys, including in 2 hours, it's going to be NIP playing Titan. They're going to be playing on Nuke as well, by the way, so that's going to be a really sick game. And I believe with NIP starting on the CT side, by the way, just to clear that up.
Oh, that's predetermined?
Yeah, in ESCA it is.
Is it in ESCA?
It's ESCA, yeah. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we have the one ESCA match in the middle of the night, but I thought we couldn't let that game go no matter what happened, really.
Yeah, that's true.
It ends 16-6 here, with the top fraggers being Uzi, and I actually see who the other one was that disconnected too quickly, but Uzi definitely top fragging at the end here. So that's it, guys. There is nothing more to say about it. Penta today wasn't their day, at least, but we'll catch them later. We'll catch them at Assembly. And as I said, I mean, as we've been saying for a while, they are a team that sometimes surprises, so don't want to write them completely off here, but everyone's allowed to have a bit of an off day too. And